Okay, this is take two. Dale Little here with Rescue America Ministries. And we just got back with Wednesday night service here recently, Unity Baptist Church. And I had planned to put some new strings on my pastor's guitar. Did not have time to before service. I was going to use it, but ended up using a different one. Didn't have time to get the strings on. Wasn't sure if it, how long they'd been on there. So I did put some on. I stayed late, and we've got some on now. And I've got about three songs. I'm not going to do the whole songs. Three hymns I was going to do. And I'm going to do them a little differently, as I do a lot of things. a different key, different timing. And some of you will like it, some won't. That's the way it always is. So I'm not going to worry about that. Just hope it'll be a blessing to somebody. The songs that are here in our hymn book today, they faced the same resistance when they came along to be put in. So, you know, I just don't worry about that too much. I've got, I think, Rock of Ages. I've got, I'm going to sing a couple verses there. Just over a couple pages, I think. Where are we at here? Oh, okay. No, I'm going to start back here. I'm sorry. Let me hurry here so I don't take much time. Start with There Is a Fountain and sing a couple verses there. Rock of Ages and then Amazing Grace. So let's get started here with There Is a Fountain. And see how this sounds with the new strings on it. There is a fountain filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's veins, and sinners once beneath that flood lose all their guilty stains, lose all their guilty stains, lose all their guilty. Rock of Ages. Rock of Ages, clip for me. Let me hide myself in thee. Let go. Only three verses here. Could my tears fall, ever flow? Could my zeal no longer know? These four sins could not atone. Thou must save, and thou alone. In my hand, no price I bring. Simply to thy cross. While I draw this fleeting breath, when my eyes Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Now suddenly, I'm off. I apologize. Sung the first verse to go over again. I forgot over here. Let's do that one again. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. His grace hath brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. 'Tis grace hath brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. You can count on that, friend, if you depend on Him. Now, someone's got eternal life, and some of you got something different. I hear people all the time say, well, if you endure to the end, yeah, quote these verses. If you endure to the end, he that endures to the end will be saved. Well, we need to take all that in context. First of all, the first time that's mentioned, I think, is one of the first times that I found. It was in Matthew chapter 10, and he specifically said, do not take this message to the Gentiles. This is for the Jewish nation. So if you're a Gentile, you know, don't worry about where it says he that endures to the end will be saved. Because what that is talking about, in both instances, later on in chapter 23 or 24, don't remember for sure which one, but it's talking about the Jewish nation. And it's talking about, in Zechariah chapter 13 and 14, where it talks about how two-thirds of the Jewish nation is going to be destroyed, killed. It's going to be bad. Only one-third will be left. But Peter said that God knows how to bring the righteous through. So it's not that they had to work to endure, and they worked and they fought hard enough that they endured to the end. Now, oh, those ones, okay, they fought hard, you know, and they survived, so these are going to be saved. No, God knows how to bring the righteous, Peter said, through these times. And he will. He will. He's brought you safe thus far. He'll take you on from here. Philippians 1:6 says that he that began a good work in you will, W-I-L-L, complete it in that day. Well, I'll tell you something. I didn't start it. He did. If I started it, I'm in trouble. If you started it, you're in trouble. But if he started it, he will complete it if you've accepted that walk. So you have either eternal life or you have something else. Eternal life lasts forever. And the Bible says that we have eternal life now. And it's in His Son, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is eternal life. It's because He dwells, He moved in when we got saved, when we asked Him into our heart. Or, you know, we may not specifically have said, Lord, come into our heart. But whatever, that's what He did. He gave us a new heart to start with. Jeremiah 17:9 says, the heart is deceitfully wicked. Who can know it? So we were born with a corrupt, incurable heart. That's another word. Another translation of that term means incurable. But over in Jeremiah chapter 24, verse 7, same prophet. He again speaks for God. He says, I'll give you a new heart, a heart to know me as Lord. That tells me that heart we were born with cannot know him as Lord. He's got to give us that new one. We've got to get that new heart, and then he will move in. He's not going to live in that old stinking dirty heart that you were born with. Corrupt. All our righteousness is filthy rags, says. But he'll give us a brand new one, and he's going to move in. Or either he did already, whatever you've done. But if you've done that, what's this stuff about, well, I have to endure to the end? That's not for you. You say, well, you know, you're free to do as you please. You're one of these, once saved, always saved. Well, you can put it that way if you want to. I call it eternal life, just like the Bible says, that he would give us eternal life. So you've either got eternal life or you've got something else that's not, it's bogus. And if you don't have eternal life, you're not going to make it. You need to start trusting Jesus Christ 100%. See, I'm free to serve him. I've heard many people say, well, even Christian people, I've heard theologians say, well, you know, our service to God is also mixed with a bit of selfishness too, because we're doing it for our own good. Well, you are if you're working, trying to work for your salvation. But I'm not doing that. I'm working out of a grateful heart. I'm serving out of a grateful heart. I'm free to do that because I don't have to worry if I do enough today or tomorrow to keep myself saved. If you're doing that, then yes, you are working from a place of selfishness. Just turn it all over to Jesus. If he paid it all on the cross, there's nothing left for me to pay. There's nothing left for me to do. Except to serve him out of a grateful heart and thanks for what he's done for me. You can do that, but not work for your salvation and feel like you have to work to keep your salvation at the same time. Trust him today. You're either putting your faith in him or you're putting your faith in yourself. Peter said that when we go talk about these verses that talk about if he that endures to the end will be saved, Peter says that God knows how to bring us through these areas of temptation. He knows how to bring us through. And just as this song here says, 'tis grace hath brought me safe thus far, and grace, not my works, grace will lead me home. If you can't say that, you might as well quit singing that song. Dale Little, I hope you're ready. I hope you know. I hope you can serve him out of a grateful heart. Dale Little, Rescue America Ministries.